I like boats, I like Arduinos, so let's build an RC boat using an Arduino. This project must be wireless, must have rudder control, main and jib sheet control, and completely home build. Otherwise, what's the point? Part one of this series will be how to build the electronics for a remote control sailboat, but this could be used for a car, airplane, just about anything. Parts you need for the receiver are an Arduino, solderless breadboard, of course an antenna and a breakout board, some wire, and a couple of servos. Transmitter, same thing, except instead of servos, I'm going to use a pot and a couple switches to control my rudder and sheet. Wiring an RF24 module to an Arduino is fairly straightforward. It's using the SPI bus, and there are plenty of pinouts on the web. I found this one that helped me connect things like MOSI, MISO, and a few other terminals. Notice I'm using the RF24 breakout board that allows me to use a 9-volt battery. If you don't have this breakout board, you can't wire your transceiver directly to 5 volts VCC. You'll burn it right out. You must connect it to 3.3 volts. Wiring the receiver is pretty easy. I'm also using a couple of servos, standard SG90 for my rudder, and a continuous servo for my raising and lowering the sail. Red to positive, brown to negative, and orange goes to one of your digital outputs. Transmitter wiring is a little bit easier, same basic process using the SPI bus. So I can control my rudder, I'm going to hook a pot across 3.3 volts ground, and the input will go right into my A0. To raise and lower the sail, I'm going to put a couple of push button switches on and simply read a high-low value and do a little bit of code logic to figure out if I should raise or lower the sail. This is a fairly straightforward wiring process for the Arduino. Let's take a look at the transmitter code first. In the source code that I provided, I've included all the pinout information in the comment block. I've also provided some links to the libraries and a nice help page on getting started with the RF24. I found it very helpful to create a structure.h file that contains a data structure so I can pass data to and from my transmitter or receiver very easily. I simply include that h file in both of my transmitter and receiver sketches. That way I have access to the same exact data structure. Here are the adjustable pins for your RF24 modules. Now I can create a data structure that's common to both my receiver and transmitter sketches. If you're not using the breakout board, you're trying to power your antenna right off your Arduino, you're probably not going to be able to put your power on high. Low or minimum is probably all you're going to be able to do. Since I'm powering mine from an external 9-volt battery using that breakout board, I can power all the way up to maximum if I want to. To control the rudder position, I'll simply map the output of the pot to the actual servo. I want a 110 degrees sweep, so that means 55 degrees on either side of 90. That's where my mapping of 35 to 145 degrees comes from. The reason I'm using the 3.3 volt and not 5 volt is that pin was just easier for me to solder to on my production board. I'll use two push buttons to trim the sail in or out, and some simple logic to detect when those buttons are pushed. Take a quick look at my if statements. If one button is pressed, the sail will go up or down. If no buttons are pressed, we'll stop the continuous servo motor. With these constant rotation motors, 0 or 180 will turn the motor full clockwise or counterclockwise. Any other value will simply set the speed of the motor. I'm slowing mine down so the strings don't jam up when I'm letting my sails out. Now that my data structure is populated, I simply call the radio.write function. The receiver code is even easier, but before we get to that, let's take a look at this structure to see how I'm passing data from the transmitter to the receiver. I think it's a lot easier to create a data structure and pass data using it as opposed to writing a parsed string. I've created a structure and stored that in a .h file, that way I can include that in both my sketches. For V1.0 of my RC controller, my data structure is pretty simple. I have an unsigned long for the current time, which I'm not even using. I've got a byte value to store the rudder position, and another byte value to store whether the sail should come in or come out. I'll simply include that in both my sketches, and I have access to the same data. Keep in mind, this file has to go in your library folder of the Arduino folder, and make sure all Arduino sketches are closed before you create this file. Now let's finish up the receiver code. Using the same address ensures the receiver can talk to the transmitter. Again, here's how I initialize my data structure using that RC packet that we just saw. Because I have two servos, I'm going to create an object for each of them, giving them a unique name. Then in my setup, I simply attach that to a dedicated pin. I'll set my power to high, but I may change it to max depending on the actual range. This antenna is good for 1,000 meters, we'll see. I'll read the data from the radio and simply write the data.rud to my rudder servo and the data.sail to my sail servo. Here's a quick example of the prototype in action. Notice the servo spinning around to raise and lower the sail, and I still have control over the rudder. Pretty cool. Next time, I'll show you how to create a custom enclosure for your Arduino project using some 3D CAD modeling and some 3D printing. Well, that's it. Thanks for watching. Don't forget to comment.